Hi, we're Vaughn and Claire from Timbu, and this is Deconstructing IoT. Today, we're exploring how applications of smart architecture can be valuable for the future of urban agriculture. Limited space, pollution, and access to sunlight are all concerns when designing a viable urban farm. Rooftop farms and urban greenhouses may offer solutions.
Vertical farming is another system that proposes to use unoccupied space in buildings and skyscrapers as an opportunity to produce vegetation in controlled environments.
We're building a system that can be used to monitor and control the delivery of natural and artificial light to different plant species in a vertical farm. We'll use an Arduino Yún to log the interior conditions. Arduino Yuns come with Timbu pre-packaged on the board, making it even easier to connect to our 2,000 plus choreos. If light conditions or temperature conditions fall outside of the ideal growing conditions of the plants when we're using natural light, we'll receive a phone call alert from Nexmo, reporting the EnviroFacts UV levels as well as the Yahoo Weather forecast for the next several hours. If UV levels are predicted to be too intense, or if the Yahoo Weather forecast predicts inadequate sunlight, we'll be given the option to remotely turn our windows from transparent to opaque and turn on our indoor artificial growing lights. We'll need an Arduino Yún, a sensor. We're using a photocell to measure light values, but you could also use a temperature sensor like this one. Two transistors in order to control the switchable glass and LED light strip from our Arduino, since they require more power than the Arduino can handle. Switchable glass, which changes from opaque to transparent when voltage is applied, and artificial growing lights. We're just using an LED strip for this demo.
I'm logged into the Timbu website on the EnviroFacts UV Forecast Hourly UV by Zip Code Choreo page. So I'll just turn IoT mode on and select my Arduino Yún. Then we'll add an input from our board to trigger the choreo. If analog pin 0 is less than 550, run the choreo. I'll include my zip code, then scroll down to the code snippet and copy and paste the code into my Arduino IDE. Next, I'll navigate to the Yahoo Weather Get Weather by Address Choreo page. I'll include my address, then scroll down to the code snippet and integrate this choreo into my existing code. You can use an output filter to isolate the data that you're interested in working with. Finally, I'll navigate to the Nexmo Voice Capture Text-to-Speech Prompt Choreo. I already have my Nexmo credentials saved into a profile, so I'll select the profile and then add a placeholder text message. Later, we can incorporate values returned by the EnviroFacts and Yahoo Weather choreos into this text message. I'll have the results of this choreo trigger a hardware event. If the digit captured is equal to 1, then write hi on. We're going to use 9 and 13, 9 for our lights and 13 for the switchable glass. Scroll down to the code snippet and then integrate this choreo into your existing code.
We have our plant set up here and an Arduino Yún, which is connected to switchable glass and an LED light strip. We also have a photocell light sensor right here. So I'm just going to upload my code to the Arduino board. And as soon as that's uploaded, we will open the serial monitor. And any second, we should start to see our sensor values coming in. So I'll just cover the photocell and try and hit that threshold that we set earlier. There we go. So it's triggering the EnviroFacts UV Forecast Hourly UV by Zip Code Choreo. And now it is running the Yahoo Weather Get Weather by Address Choreo to get the weather forecast. And any second it should be calling my phone to ask if we want to switch the glass and turn on the lights. There it is.
That's all there is to it. You could extend this application by searching the Wolfram Alpha API for ideal growing conditions of different plant species. You could extend this application by using parse to log ideal and changing conditions of crops, or you could add email notification alerts whenever they're necessary. You could even inform the community of ready-to-be-picked crops and use Stripe to accept payment before they've even been picked.
We love hearing what Tembu users are working on.
Have a project you'd like to see us build? Or an IoT idea you'd like us to feature? Get in touch at hey@tembu.com.
And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. You won't want to miss what we have in store for you next week.